the Prudential Halftime Report. Brought to you by Prudential. When it comes to insurance, real estate, and investments, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the rock. The Prudential. Rock solid. From New York, John Saunders.
Florida State scored 70 points and 69 points, respectively, in the last couple of weeks. They're well on their way once again with 38-17 lead right now over Florida. We'll have more in the second half in a moment. But first, time for the Prudential Halftime Report. We'll start off with another in-state matchup that's a pretty good rivalry. Mississippi State and Ole Miss. First quarter, Doug Innocent is guilty this time. He fumbles it. Charlie Davidson picks it up. Mississippi State in business. Second quarter, Greg Plupp, 48 yards to Orlando Truitt. This sets up a 22-yard field goal and a 10-0 lead for Mississippi State. But Ole Miss coming back as Russ Shouse goes to Marvin Courtney. 6 yards on this touchdown toss to get them on the board. That's where they stand now, 10-7. Rice and Houston. Jimmy Klingler in action early, looking for Freddie Gilbert. 32 yards. This one will cover. The second touchdown pass of the day for Klingler as he steps up in the pocket, fires, and Gilbert does the rest of the work in Houston. Klingler's also tossed an 18-yard touchdown pass to Keith Jack. They have the lead there. Division I AA playoffs. Delaware leading Samford 28-7. Bill Vergantino, 2 touchdown passes, and ran one in for Delaware as well, 28-7 there. Eastern Kentucky and Marshall. Michael Payton has just thrown one to Troy Brown, 37 yards. They lead 17-0. North Carolina A&T trailing the Citadel, 13-0. Jack Douglas, 1-yard touchdown run. Cedric Sims, a 2-yard touchdown run. And Villanova facing Youngstown State. Tamron Smith, 1-yard touchdown run there to make it 13-10 is the score there. It has been a very rough year for coaches in the NCAA. In fact, it's been a rough couple of weeks. Let's take a look at some of the more notable names. Johnny Majors, they bought out his contract. Phil Fulmer, his assistant, will likely take over. Pat Dye, he resigned this week under pressure. The university has a search committee to find a new coach. Earl Bruce was fired, admitting some NCAA violations, but he denies others. He's considering legal action. Jerry Burke tossed out and replaced by Ron Dickerson, the only black head coach in Division 1A. We'll talk to him later. And Paul Hackett, rather, was allowed to resign. Sal Cinceri has been named the interim coach. And joining me now is Dick Vermeil. And Dick, the question is, most of the presidents will tell you what they want their coaches to do is graduate their players. But the fact of the matter is, if you don't win, you're going to be out of there.
Well, John, I agree with you. And going around doing college football broadcasts, I always spend some time visiting with the coaches, both Brent and I do. And I think all the coaches agree with the college presidents and their program to keep motivating kids to graduate. But that's not only the coach's responsibility. That's the school's responsibility as well. But to say that that's the number one thing, get to the graduation rate, who are we kidding? I mean, you can graduate 70% of your class, but if you aren't better than 7-3, and if you've been 7-3 for a long time and haven't been to the major bowl, you're going to get fired. That's expected. The alumni expect it. That's how they make the money to pay for the entire athletic program off the football team and basketball team.
All right, Dick, thank you very much. We'll get back to you in the second half along with Brent Musburger. But coming up next on the Prudential Halftime Report, we'll take a look inside of black college football. Some of the greater names in the game have emerged. We'll also talk to Ron Dickerson, the only black head coach in Division I.
Changes, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the Prudential, rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate. constant change, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the Prudential. Rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate.
Welcome back, everyone, to New York and the Prudential Halftime Report. Let's look at a couple more scores right now. Grambling facing Southern U, a game that'll start at 2:30 Eastern time. Grambling headed to the Heritage Bowl in a rematch with Florida A&M, a game they won 27-10. Right now, Florida A&M facing Bethune-Cookman, leading 7-0. Earl Reeves has a 6-yard touchdown run there. Now, earlier this year, we told you that black college football was celebrating 100 years of action. But to many, including many of the stars they have launched, it's actually the small college atmosphere that's the key. On a typical November Saturday afternoon in Tallahassee, a football fan must sometimes make a choice. 2 weeks ago, while Florida State was hosting Tulane, less than a mile away, Florida A&M was playing a big game against Grambling. Florida A&M, like other black college football programs, offers a smaller, more personal approach. It's the type of environment that former Chicago Bear great Walter Payton was searching for when he elected to attend Jackson State.
Not every kid is ready to go away from home to a major university, because some of the universities that I was looking at, the population of the students that went to school there was more than my hometown. Jackson State gave me an opportunity to do a lot of things that to enhance my football productivity. I ran kicks back, I punted, I kicked off, I kicked field goals and extra points, and I ran the ball, I caught the ball, I threw the ball. If I'd have went to probably a major university, I probably wouldn't have got an opportunity to do that.
Florida A&M is coached by Ken Riley, a 15-year National Football League veteran with the Cincinnati Bengals, who's returned to the smaller confines of his alma mater.
At the larger school, there's so much emphasis on winning. There's a lot of time that's consumed. Not to say that we're not doing the same thing on this level, but the pressure to win is a lot greater. Consequently, there's more time spent in trying to prepare student athletes to do the things necessary in order to win.
A perennial All-Pro, San Francisco 49er wide receiver Jerry Rice attended Mississippi Valley State and was comfortable in a smaller setting.
They can really teach you and bring you along and take time out with you. In other big colleges, they're not going to do that.
The athletes that are there now, they're good, but you have to spend some time with. You have to, it's sort of like a diamond in the rough. And that's what these coaches are doing, such as an Eddie Robinson. He's molding these players into quality citizens.
If he graduates and if he gets a chance to go into his chosen profession, he gets a shot at pro ball and things like that, then what else is it? You go any place you want to go.
And it doesn't matter if it's at Jackson State, Florida A&M, Florida State, Notre Dame, or USC. You know, wherever, make sure that it's a place where you want to be and it's going to afford you the opportunity to make yourself better.
And while black college football has continued to prosper, that has not been the case for college football coaches, at least in Division 1A. Joining me now is Ron Dickerson, the newly named head coach at Temple University. He is the only black head coach in Division 1A. We'll get to that in a moment. But first, Coach, yesterday, last night, you had a chance to watch your son. Pretty good game, 6 for 69 and one touchdown.
He had a great game, and we were excited as a family to watch him in his final game and his catches and everything was just a climax of a wonderful week.
As you say, it's been a terrific week for you, getting named the head coach at Temple. Temple has struggled over the last 2 years, just 3-19. What's your first move to get the program headed in the right direction in the Big East?
Well, John, first thing we got to do is we got to cultivate the fans, the recruits in the greater Philadelphia area. And we really have to do a great job, not just in the greater Philadelphia area, but in Maryland and New York, New Jersey, that entire area. Try to encompass a 200-mile radius of Philadelphia.
Temple University has 5 black head coaches right now, including, of course, yourself and John Chaney, who's very well spoken for college basketball. But in Division 1A college football, you are now the only black head coach. Is enough being done to promote blacks in the sport that they dominate, really?
Well, I think that I'm really proud of the president and the athletic director at Temple University for obviously hiring me, but I think they bit the bullet. They told the entire nation, hey, bow your back and do what you talk about doing, and don't just put it on paper. Temple has done it, and they've gone out and hired, obviously, five coaches that they feel are outstanding coaches, not just necessarily black. They've hired the best coaches they can find for their particular sport. And I think that if the other universities' presidents and administrators did the same, things would be a whole lot better in college athletics.
And very quickly, I know Bill Cosby was involved in your hiring a great alumnus there at Temple. What was your experience with Mr. Cosby?
Well, he's very sincere and very honest and very humorous, obviously, but he loves Temple University, and he's very proud of Temple University, and he wants the best for Temple University, and I felt honored to have an opportunity to sit down with him and discuss my future and the future of Temple football.
All right, Ron, thank you very much for joining us from Tulsa, and good luck next season. When we continue, we'll have more on the Prudential Halftime Report, then back to Florida and Florida State in a moment.
Sweeping changes, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the Prudential, rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate.
The NCAA is about standards of fair play. These standards are the basis of competition for the more than 700 members of the association. The primary role of the Committee on Infractions is to assure that these standards of fair play and competition are upheld. We care deeply about intercollegiate athletics and strive diligently to make decisions that are in the best interest of the member institutions, their student athletes, and coaches.
This message provided by the NCAA.
Welcome back. Later tonight, a very big matchup in San Diego as number one Miami goes up against San Diego State. It's also the head-to-head matchup of Gino Toretta and this man, Marshall Faulk. Now, Faulk, as you know, has a sprained right knee, took a limited number of carries in practice this week, but they say he will play as Toretta and Faulk go head-to-head for the Heisman Trophy Award. We'll keep you updated on that during our primetime game between USC and Notre Dame. For a preview of that game, Keith Jackson.
Tonight on ABC Sports College Football, one of the great rivalries in the history of the game. 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 o'clock Pacific, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame and the Trojans of Southern California get it on at the Coliseum in Los Angeles. Both teams headed for postseason play. The Irish rolling off a pretty good season, Bob Greasy, and Rick Meyer, four-year starter at quarterback for Lou Holtz, closing out his career in a blaze of glory.
I really like this young man. I think he has done an outstanding job at Notre Dame. If you can be an unappreciated player at Notre Dame, I think he has been. He is the career leader in total offense at Notre Dame, and he is fourth ranked in the nation in passing.
Larry Smith has changed the look of the Southern California offense.
Well, it's no longer student body right and left. It's more of a big play offense. One of the reasons, Curtis Conway, the wide receiver, he has returned a kickoff for a touchdown, a punt return for a touchdown. He has run a reverse for a touchdown, and he has thrown a pass for a touchdown. This young man can do it all.
So, the Irish with nine consecutive wins over the Trojans. Lou Holtz has spent all week warning his people about how dangerous USC can be when they're backed into a corner. And he has really been working on them. It's a burr under USC's saddle that they have lost nine in a row. And they still have that white horse, except they still haven't figured out a way to run him at fullback.
All right, Keith and Bob, we'll see you at 8 o'clock Eastern time. That's it for the Prudential Halftime Report. I'm John Saunders from New York right now. Back to Florida and Florida State.
From ABC Sports, the Prudential Halftime Report has been brought to you by Prudential. When it comes to insurance, real estate, and investments, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the rock. The Prudential. Rock solid.
Five touchdowns and one field goal in eight possessions. Florida State with a first half explosion against Florida. Second half is coming up on ABC.
One of these engines was filled with Castrol Syntec, a new synthetic oil. The rest with conventional oils. They were then drained and started without oil to prove a point. You ABC Syntec's unique molecular structure bonds to engine parts. Lab tests show it leaves a layer of protection far stronger than conventional oil. And if Syntec protects this well now, imagine if you leave it in. Castrol Syntec protects in ways other oils can't.
I have to admit, I'm a little surprised.
About what?
I just never thought I'd see you in anything but a BMW or a Lexus.
Me neither.
Airbag? Leather? This is quality. Expensive?
About 10, 15,000 less than the BMW or Lexus. I think it feels just as good.
What? Oh, this Pontiac Bonneville. It's amazing.
$4,573 real NFL plays of real NFL teams are now available in your living room.
Imagine a rent-a-car company that offers special delivery right to your door. That's Enterprise.
Here, let me help you.
Enterprise, a special rent-a-car company that gives you special delivery.
Just a hoot and a holler from Nashville's Grand Ole Opry. It's another place that's home to musicians from all over the world. It's Groon Guitars, where they sell rare and vintage instruments to everyone from Johnny Cash to Motley Crue. So if you go, remember, bring your pick and your Visa card. Because at Groon, you can take your licks on a 1939 Martin, but you can't take it home with American Express.
Yeah.
Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
CFA College Football. This ABC Sports exclusive, brought to you by Pontiac and your nearby Pontiac dealers. We are driving excitement. And by Xerox, the document company.
It's 38-17, and let's go downstairs to Mark Jones.
Brent, Dick Ruland usually uses a one-inch tee for kickoffs, but now he's gone to a two-inch tee. He's shaved it down just a touch, and they're going to try and pop it up and keep it away from the man.
And the man is number 80 with 214 combined yards in the first half. He attended high school right here in Tallahassee at Leon High School. He scored 45 touchdowns for that school. He was also a talented defensive back. Picked off 8 passes and returned 2 of those for touchdowns. So he has stepped out of the phone booth. And here he is at the 5-yard line with the big S in the center of his chest, and he's ready to go again. And Ruland says, let's bring it on. So from the 1, here comes Vanover. Vanover does not escape this time. Pounded at the 23-yard line. Oliver amongst those in on the coverage. And let's take a look at our statistics from the first half, Coach Vermeil.
Well, you know, here you've got a total offense output of 278 yards for Florida, you know, and for Florida State. And Florida hasn't done a bad job, you know. Turnovers, Florida State 0, Florida 2. Time and possession. Hey, Florida's had a little bit more, but hasn't done as good a job with the ball.
Wonderful starting field position, led by those two kickoff returns of 80 and 76 yards. Now it is Ward, the point man for the basketball team, throwing high and incomplete. Ward is out of Thomasville, Georgia. That is not far from Tallahassee. His family can drive here in about 45 minutes. Folks, when he was a freshman, he became the starting punter for this football team. There were some injuries and other things, and that's how Ward began his career. Then in the ACC a year ago as the point guard for Pat Kennedy's basketball team, he led that conference in steals with 4.4 a game. And here he is backing into the shotgun, lifts his leg, the center lifts his head, takes on the rush man. It's Floyd on the inside handoff. And the only complaint you ever get about Bobby Bowden in Tallahassee is that sometimes he is too conservative. But this attack today has been anything but conservative for the most part. And Coach Bowden is relying more and more on his assistant coaches, Mr. Vermeil, to call the plays.
That's true. But, you know, this was not a design plan preseason. They flopped into the shotgun by having so much success in the two-minute offense. They said, why wait for 2 minutes? Let's just go with it.
Here it is, third and 9, and they've got to go with something here. Again, the offensive line lets it hold up for him, and he throws a beautiful ball to Vanover over on the side, and Larry Kennedy is there defensively. I'll tell you what, he really drops the ball in like a pure passer, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. He puts it where it's catchable. And the bad throw, it makes the wide receiver work for it. At the top of your screen, it's going to be the deep out pattern, man-to-man coverage. See, now he comes back. See, he comes back for the ball. The ball is throwing, pulling him away from number three, Larry Kennedy. Excellent route, excellent throw.
Vanover, let's see, the record he's after is 422 yards in a game. That was Marshall Faulk a year ago. He's got a ways to go. And now it is Ward pulling back. Look how he just steps away from the pressure and gets close down to midfield. Just a wonderful little run using his head. And this is how they turn the offense over to him. He makes the decisions out there.
You know, and seeing being back there in the shotgun, when he starts up in there, you know, he can see he's used to being that point guard and flipping the ball off one way or the other. He never shows or appears to be in a panic situation. He always seems cool.
The ball at the Seminoles 49-yard line. And the Gators put four linemen down on that defensive line. And they're coming linebacker after on the left side, and he's indicating that he wants to come after Ward, and now they do come from the other side, and a beautiful play by Miles that time, who was stepping into that gap, and it's going to be second and long.
You know, Ron Zook has made a little adjustment with the defense, Brent. They're coming into a blitz, but they're showing it late. See, and then they can't make the adjustments offensively to either pick it up or to audible, so they're hitting them with pretty good timing there and screwing up offensive timing.
Vanover and McCorvey, the two wide receivers to Ward's left. Then Knox, who caught 11 passes in the first half, is off to the short side of the field. Running backs both release, and Ward goes deep down the right side to Knox. Interference.
He caught it anyway, didn't he?
Penalty flags come flying.
He laid that one there, got it up in the air real good. Now, you want to get it up there over the outside shoulder of the wide receiver, or you teach the receiver to run to the inside of the ball to keep the defender away from it. See, now he's outside. If he keeps it out there, see where he is, right? He's in good position right there. He's just a little bit short. He ended up with the ball on that, huh?
Well, the discussion, you know, this is not like the NFL. And if they're going to move the ball down there, it's going to be a catch. Now here, if he made the catch down there and they decline it, this is going to be a 47-yarder and going to be first and goal. But if not, it's only a 10-yard penalty that's marked off on interference. And now they're starting to come back.
Obviously saying he didn't catch the football.
Well, I think Larry Kennedy actually wound up with the ball, didn't he, when he
took it out late. Yeah, he stripped it out of there late, it looked like, on that shot. He had a pretty good shot of it. We'll take another look at it here when we get it set up in the trucks. Here it is. See it here now, right there in the middle of your screen. There's the ball. Comes down. He's got it right now. He's caught the footload. Doesn't have full control yet. There, you can see it right there. He has it. That's a completed pass.
I think it should be first and goal.
Goal. Yeah, it's first and goal. It wasn't in a perfect position on his body, but the ball was not moving around. He had it clamped.
Knox is some receiver. Now, the referee marked the 15-yard penalty up. I think a moment ago I said it was 10. I was wrong on that. It's a 15-yard penalty, and they mark it off on pass interference. It's unlike the NFL rule. If they had called interference in the NFL, obviously it would have been first and goal down there, but not at the college game. That rule was changed a few years back. All right, so now it is first and 10 for the Seminoles. The ball is inside the 35-yard line. Ward operating from the shotgun. Blitz by Brooks, and the pass is complete. McCorvey coming across is hit by Spear.
Here we can take one more look. Top left-hand corner of your screen, you'll see the ball coming down. There's the interference. Now he reaches back and tucks it in right on the number one. He has the ball. He's down. The ball is coming out as he goes down.
So it was Groh closing in on Ward. The ball at the Florida 23-yard line, and Ward getting time, fires complete to Baker inside the 5-yard line. Well, it just took him a couple more plays to get first and goal anyway.
That's it. They're going to get it back down there. See, too much time to throw against man-to-man coverage. Both the slot receiver went inside and settled in. Then the outside, Shannon Baker, turns back to the inside, and he throws the rifle shot for the completion.
This is some offense. Now Fryer, the wide receiver, into the left. Ward is under center, and Floyd will be the fullback set in front of the tailback.
Ooh, look at that block.
Wow. Right ahead.
I'd love to see a fullback block like that. You know, Brent, we've seen a number of good fullbacks this year that blocked well, but boy, Floyd is as good as any of them.
That was Sean Jackson carrying the ball behind that block by the fullback that time. And now it is second and goal from the one. You would think it would be pretty easy for Ward to keep the ball and go on in. They're going to load up with Crockett, the additional fullback. Now, they ran away from Crockett down here one time for a touchdown. And this is Floyd into the end zone. Touchdown, Florida State. And the neon twinkles again in Tallahassee.
They're in an unbalanced line. They bring the big tackle over from the other side. They move both tackles over to the left side of the formation. Get a lot of bulk over there, a couple 280-pounders, and just hand it off in reverse pivot. He just puts those pads down and goes in. You know, and the running back himself weighs 240.
Florida State. Maybe Dick Reveal is wrong.
Mr. Reveal, you know I'm never wrong.
Just because you got 2.3 kids. Just because you got a house, a lawn, and a mortgage. Just because you're now a responsible adult. You still know how to have a good time, don't you?
The new Grand Am Sports Sedan.
Our instructions had an error, and 1,000 orders were due Friday.
With the speed of a Xerox digital color copier, you'll get this order on the road again. Intelligent color for any document, only from Xerox. Putting it together.
We'd like color in our copies, but what small business can afford it?
With Xerox Highlight Color, concerns about the cost of color disappear with just a touch. Intelligent color for any document, only from Xerox.
Putting it together.
Ace Best Buys are terrific values every month, like these.
This Proctor Silex 12-cup pause and serve coffee maker is just $12.96, and Ace 70 mini light sets are only $2.88.
Ace Best Buys.
Another reason Ace is the place.
For you.
In a world of constant change, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the rock. The Prudential. Rock solid.
Longtime rivals collide. The fifth-ranked Fighting Irish of Notre Dame head west for a primetime war with the Trojans of USC tonight on ABC's College Football.
Renegade, the horse, is very happy that Chief Osceola doesn't treat him like USC used to treat Traveler. Otherwise, he'd be exhausted running around this field after every score.
Especially when they played my team.
You grew to love that horse in the Coliseum. And Frazier grabs it before it goes out of bounds. And he's got an alley for the Gators, 40 and out of bounds at the 43-yard line. And now it is Florida's turn after that scoring drive by Florida State to see what they can get going here against this Seminole defense. Next Saturday, a great tradition at noon Eastern time. Army-Navy, followed by the Southeastern Championship game from Birmingham, presented by Dr. Pepper. That one matches Florida. The Gators have changed quarterbacks as Terry Dean now in for his first play. And he is smothered at the 41-yard line. That was Freeman bringing him down. What about Terry Dean, Coach?
Well, Terry's only thrown four passes coming into this game, completed four of them. One pass interception, no touchdowns. He's scrambled all right, though. He's got almost a four-yard average scrambling.
You've seen him throw a couple of his passes in Knoxville, Tennessee.
That's right.
He stepped in during a fierce rainstorm up there. Now four down linemen. Jones coming on a blitz, and they drop it off low and incomplete.
You know, when you're trying to throw the layoff pass against the blitz coverage, you really got to be careful as a quarterback, because there'll be a man assigned to latch onto him and be standing there waiting for that layoff pass. You know, we're raving about Florida State's offense, Brent. They came into this ballgame number 12 in the country on defense, you know.
Yeah, they're not too bad on this side of the ball either, are they? I thought that Alabama got better penetration with its defensive line.
Oh, yeah. I think Alabama's defense is better all the way around.
And dropped. Good defense that time. It was Sawyer.
Good close. Ball in the air. He's demonstrated that already. They've done a great job on third down defense all year. That's a real credit to their defensive coaching staff, Mickey Andrews and Wally Burnham. And
that's the team doctor. Shane Matthews, early in this game, suffered an injury. Mark Jones told us from downstairs that there was heavy bleeding. I believe it was the left toe when he was stepped on. Then he was stepped on a second time. Here is a low Florida punt, bouncing to Sawyer at the 18 and down at the 21-yard line. And here comes the Seminoles' fast break again. 45-17. And when you come back, they've got the ball again.
Here they come from Radio Shack. Radio-controlled cars for supercharged fun. The new fast Black Phantom burns up the straightaway.
Watch me make this turn.
The new twin-motor Blue Flash has super grip tread.
Hills are no problem.
As tough as they come, the 4x4 off-roader takes on the rough terrain. And the jumbo van carries cargo with style.
I'm out of here.
Radio-controlled cars for kids big and small. From Radio Shack, your Christmas electronics store.
Yeah, I looked at the BMW and the Lexus.
And?
I drove this. The power, the handling, the control. It was incredible.
Really?
It's got leather, ABS, dual airbags. It's even supercharged. I could have spent a lot more on the BMW or the Lexus. But why?
What is this?
The new Pontiac SSEI.
We are driving.
Very nice.
Excitement, Pontiac.
There's one battery that backs you with free jumpstart service anywhere, for any reason. Die Hard.
Can't believe I left my lights on.
Sears Die Hard. The battery you can count on to give you more power when you need it most.
Tom Cruise. Jack Nicholson. Demi Moore. A Rob Reiner film. A Few Good Men. Rated R. At Sears, December 11th.
Well, Florida State leading 45-17 and enjoying their new britches, which were purchased by one Burt Reynolds a few weeks back. Cost old Burt around $9,000 to contribute that to his alma mater, and the youngsters appreciate it. Here they are climbing all over the Gators. Ward from the shotgun, gracefully firing it outside. He's friendly.
clearance free before he's finally down at the 31-yard line. It's Kez McCorvey was the receiver, and we had an opportunity to ask Ward about his maturity this year as the leader, and here's what he had to say.
The beginning of the season, it was more, you know, I was learning. It was a new offense we were learning. And, you know, I just had a lot of pressure trying to read defenses, trying to do things that that I'm not doing now, you know, just relaxing. And I was just trying to force a lot of things, and I got in trouble with throwing a lot of interceptions. And now, you know, I'm just more relaxed and taking what the defense gives me underneath and, you know, going downfield when I need to. And it's just a matter of growing up.
They almost gave him a touchdown that time, folks. He had Knox working deep.
There's a new total offense record, huh? 3,051 yards. Congratulations, young man. You know, the first 57 passes he threw this year, 8 of them were interceptions. Doesn't look like the same guy, does it?
Doesn't. That's just a few more yards than old Burke made as a running back.
just quite a few yards, I think. Which movie are you talking about?
But he's a good bandit. And here's Ward firing to the right side. Knox again. Working that sideline and out of bounds at the 42.
See, they blitzed that time. They brought like 7, maybe 8 people on that blitz. But he's back there already. They picked up the inside of it. And he just pops it out there. Everybody in coordination to the quick receiver. There's Coach Ron Zook, the defensive coordinator.
Four down linemen for the Gators. And Ward with a penalty flag. Now the umpire chimes in, and Ward slides to midfield. It's possible that we've got a holding call back there.
So you have to stay in those lanes, and you have to rush. Yes, you want to rush with intensity, but you have to rush with intelligence. Because if you get out of your lane...
Offense, 10 yards. By the foul.
You get out of your lane, you give him a little hole, he's already sitting back there, and all of a sudden, here comes the fast break. Up through those holes he goes. In the other tape I looked at, Brent, one time he did that, he charged the line of scrimmage, he was going to run, he stopped right at the line of scrimmage and threw a strike about 40 yards downfield, right on the money.
Now Ward, here's McCorvey again. Down at the 40-yard line. Now we go to Mark Jones. Mark.
Brent, Dick, just in case you guys were wondering about the condition of quarterback Shane Matthews, I made eye contact with him a few moments ago. He gave me the thumbs up. He pointed towards his foot, said it's okay. They're just resting him, I would suppose, for next week's SEC championship game.
Yeah, behind this far, they could be looking ahead already toward... an important date, the Sugar Bowl at stake next week. Complete to the 45-yard line.
Pass is complete to number 12.
Now, we want to show you a moment as we went down to Mark. Dick Vermeil, here's something for you to evaluate.
Kez McCorvey. Now, I know the wide receiver coach didn't teach him how to do this. The gymnastics coach had to teach him to do this. Watch this. Oop. Can you do that, Musburger? I can picture you being able to do that.
Huh? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm out for that hurts looking at that deal, huh? Yeah. I mean, how relaxed are they? Folks, they're turning somersaults over this one already, and they're playing their arch rival. I mean, what's going on here? The crowd is quiet. They're saying, come on, Gators, fight back, fight back. Now Ward.
He's got one deep.
Does he have time or what? Deflected to... and out of bounds, or it might have been picked off. John Saunders, what do you got for us, big fella?
Intended for number 12.
Brent, we'll go back to the Southwest Conference. Rice in Houston, Lamar Smith, 19 yards up the gut into the end zone. That made it 31-7. It's now 31-14 Houston. Brent.
John, regardless, it has been a wonderful season for Rice.
Deep for the Gators, number 81.
One of the smallest schools playing, Division I AA, and they have had a fine year down there in the Southwest Conference. Florida State hunts it away, and the ball will roll dead there just inside the 19-yard line. So when you come back, it'll be the Gators' ball. They trail at 45-17.
So, I see you changed your mind, huh?
Well, the Camry was nice. Mm-hmm. And then I drove this.
Yeah.
Mileage is better.
Really? And with the power, I'm telling you, it's like a sports car with room for the kids.
Probably set you back, huh?
About 3,000 less than the Camry.
No kidding.
No kidding.
Well, what is it?
The new Grand Am.
It's a Pontiac. We are driving,
Pontiac. Really looks nice.
In Europe, things happen on time. Right on schedule. Punctuality is the norm. And that makes Europe the ideal environment for UPS. Fact is, UPS has built the most comprehensive delivery network in Europe. So when you have a shipment going there that has to be on time, use the delivery company whose punctuality is a time-honored tradition. UPS. We run the tightest ship in Europe.
Ben and Connie Studebaker look at things differently since they became parents. I'm Roger Kuhl. I'm their State Farm agent. Having a family brought a lot of changes in their lives, so we thought it was a good idea to sit down and have a family insurance checkup. We started by adding to their life insurance protection. Then we went over all their family insurance to help make sure their coverage was up to date. After all, you never know what could happen.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Brent Couples, Tom Kite, Greg Norman, and Payne Stewart. Four of golf's leading men see who's the king of swing in the Skins game. Next on ABC Sports.
In a few years, you won't recognize old Bill Campbell Stadium. Major facelift. They're going to put some classrooms in that structure around the stadium, which is undergoing renovations. You can see some of the work here. And a new record, 68,311, and you can see that when they finish, they expect to have a capacity in excess of 70,000 down here in Tallahassee. Bobby Bowden in his 17th year as the head football coach. He has broken even with the Gators in his previous 16 meetings. He is headed toward an advantage and one that would send Steve Spurrier to 1-2. Eric Rett pulls away from a defender and makes his way.
They had faked a reverse on that play, and actually the reverse did draw a defender.
The defense is so quick. The down linemen, Brent, have real good speed. You know, it's, yes, they're big, but boy, they can run.
So Steve Spurrier elects to rest Shane Matthews for his appointment next week against Alabama. And the backup quarterback, Dean, now at the controls of the game.
Fumblers fumbles the snap.
Pulling away.
You know, I'm not saying it's wrong in making that substitution, Brent, but what it does, it sends a bad message to the rest of the squad that maybe you're conceding and you want to get him ready for next week, yet we still have a half a football left to play, you know. And I think that takes an edge off your squad mentally.
Takes an edge off some of those Florida backers around the state, too, I might add. Ball is back at the 14-yard line. Three wide receivers out to the right. Now Dean, he'll run. Great
Got
catch.
It. Got it.
Ball at the 41-yard line of Willie Jackson, the leading receiver for the Gators and in the Southeastern Conference, making a dandy catch on that throw by Dean for a 27-yard gain. And you were talking about the defense, and these are the numbers.
Yeah, you can see what the Florida's up against in trying to come back. My gosh, 14.8 a game. That's number 10 in the country, number one in the ACC. They're just number one in everything.
Willie Jackson, Jack Jackson, Trey Everett to the left of Dean. Here's Willie again. And a penalty marker comes flying. Jackson across midfield to the Seminoles 49-yard line. And Trey Everett coming over there may have been assessed the penalty here on an illegal block. Let's see what they come up with.
Holding.
Yeah.
Holding penalty.
Holding offense.
10 yards from the spot of foul. Still be a first down.
Yeah, that's who the holding was on. They marched the 10 yards off, and it'll take it on back to the 38-yard line. So now it is a first down for Dean and the Gators. Marvin Jones is
looks like
3 yards off the line. They blitz from the outside. Ooh. And they have got Dean corralled at the 28-yard line. That was Freeman leading the charge.
See, they brought more defenders than you had pass protectors to pick them up. He didn't see it quick enough to unload the football. Again, you can see, though, Fuller shows up late. See, he shows up, he gets picked up, but now right up inside come the rest of the folks. John Nance, number 97, was right in there. See, you could see that coming, though, because the coverage was so much tighter on all the receivers.
So the sophomore quarterback from Naples getting an education here, and Terry Dean going to sprint out to the right with the defenders in hot pursuit, and again, he was able to get the ball into Aubrey Hill's hands that time. Fuller was there defensively, and he has thrown fairly well on the run a couple of times.
He's done a good job, and you said he's getting an education, you know, here in the ball game. But, you know, he's the kind of student that all coaches like to have. SEC Academic All-Conference, you know, here he is, just a sophomore quarterback. 3.9 GPA, that's almost straight A. You aren't going to confuse him.
Across the line.
Intercepted.
It's not
go.
And taking it back was Jack Jackson.
Pass is complete to number one, Jack Jackson.
Heads up play. Heads up play. Watch this now. Back to the right-hand corner of your screen. Watch this. He just takes it right away from him. What a nice job. LaVon Brown feels he's been robbed on that one, number 31.
So they bring the chains across the way. And a first down for Florida.
You know, we were talking about that other young quarterback coming back that's signaling over there on the sideline, that the quarterback of the future. Terry Dean's proving that he can play as well.
That young man is a redshirt, learning the system. And Steve Spurrier obviously has the future in mind, but the coach is frustrated about what is unfolding here in Tallahassee, isn't he? Dean, pressure, almost intercepted, and Alexander batted the ball and was almost picked off by another defensive lineman. In there.
The kind of athletes they have playing downline position, Brent, you just called Alexander a five-sport athlete in high school, the first one in the history of the school. So, I mean, here he is playing defensive end as a down lineman in college football. Good athlete. He gets that hand up there, right in good rhythm of the throw, and bats it back.
One of the five sports, obviously, volleyball. Oh, second down and 10. Dean, blitz, gets it off. This is Rhett, and Eric Rhett is into Seminole territory. Out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Coach had to like that play for a first down.
He had to, and good reaction by the quarterback at getting it out there on the blitz. Some linebacker should have been assigned to him coming out of the backfield that quickly right there. He didn't pick it up.
So Dean moves the Gators to the Seminole 36-yard line here in the third quarter. Dean just overthrew the receiver, Hill.
Pass was intended for number 82, Aubrey Hill.
Dean, they moved the pocket this time. They didn't come straight back, and they just moved it out. One, they, oh, he gets his foot stepped on right there, too. Oh, look at it. Oh, my footsies. It's also the left one.
I'm going to hire Dr. Scholl as the team trainer over there of the Gators before this baby's over.
Second down and 10. Now Dean straight back. Incomplete. Overthrew his tight end, Keller.
See, he overthrew him, Brent, because he didn't get set up. He threw the ball falling away, and the ball's going to go up high on those short passes when you do that. You've got to get set up to throw accurately. Now, he's really interested in the game, isn't he? Coach Furrier feels the same way.
Yeah, not alone in his emotions. Not to worry, the Seahawks are playing Monday night.
Here is third down. And Dean with Rhett behind him. Now Dean takes off. Ended at the 30-yard line. Fowler and Jones over there on the side. So, Marvelous Marvin, have we seen the end of you here in Tallahassee? You going to go to the NFL next year?
I know Marvin is getting eat up with that right now. You know, that's facing him and his family. And Marvin will do, I'm sure, what's best for him and his family, because his family plays a big role, and I personally think he'll be gone.
On fourth down, the Gator offense is gone. Seminoles ball.
You know, you still like to see him stay in school, because those that do end up being a little more successful in the National Football League over the period of year. You see this graphic here. They end up making a little bit more money, and they stay a few more years. And every situation is different. But, boy, I'll tell you, he'll line up and play next year in the first game.
Yeah, he is a player with that great speed.
Three-year starter.
So here's Ward under center, and the guard on his left side moved, broke the count, and that'll cost the Seminoles 5 yards.
Hit ball.
It'll be first and 15.
False start offense.
Big Louis Tire, number 66, was the offensive lineman, getting excited about going to block somebody in a running game. He's getting tired of that shotgun pass blocking. Engineering student here at school.
Gonna come Oliver on the blitz. They pitch to Jackson away from it, and he is stopped at the 24-yard line. Monty Groh, number 10.
Monty Groh's a tough guy. He plays that bandit Gatorback position, which is sometimes like a strong safety, sometimes like a defensive end, and he plays them both very well. Aggressive young man.
45-17, Florida State over Florida. Now back in the shotgun is Ward. Four-man rush, offensive line holds up, and it's incomplete. And that a poorly thrown pass that time. One of the few of Ward, as he and a receiver didn't communicate that time.
As you said, maybe he's getting bored, huh?
Well, you won't be bored by this, because coming up next, one of the most entertaining events in golf. It's from the Bighorn Golf Club in Palm Desert, California. Shark will be there, and Tom Kite, Freddie Couples, and the defending champion, Payne Stewart. Skins game, and always one of the more entertaining events in golf, isn't it? Now it is third down for the Seminoles. And Ward, under pressure, completes the ball to Shannon Baker.
And you see what Baker did? He went to the first down. I mean, he went right down to the first down to make the first down. Did a good job. Here he is, number one, the top of your screen. He's bursting up inside there. They're running cross pattern. See, they're playing zone. Now he's running on the safety and doing that. See the safety up here from the left side of your screen? Here he comes. He knew where that first down marker was. Shannon Baker's the fastest man to ever play here, and he's going to be about an inch short. I gave him credit too much. Did too much credit, guy, huh? Two fingers.
The crowd wants blood.
Oh, he'll go for it. He'll go for it.
There's Coach Bowden's son with Samford suffering at the hands of Delaware today in that game.
You know, the last few weeks, this first unit offense hasn't been able to play in the game because they were so far ahead at halftime that this is the first time they're getting some third quarter work.
Moves up behind center and is fourth and inches.
And they don't get it. Florida ball as Eddie Robinson storms the gates.
They hit it. Did Eddie ever hit that on time? An inspirational-type football player. He's made 233 tackles while playing at Florida, and that was one of the bigger tackles. Nice hit. But, you know, a linebacker can't make that kind of play unless the defensive coordinator calls the defense that allows him to run through like that, and Ron Zook made a real good call.
So let's see what Florida, Steve Spurrier, and Dean have in mind here. Kelvin Randolph, there was confusion about the lineup necessary. Trey Everett and Kelvin Randolph couldn't get it straight as to who was to be on the field. And so Dean and Spurrier will huddle up, and that was a long meeting.
Yeah, that was a real long meeting. I tell you, Spurrier does a lot of clever things with the football. You know, and he did a lot of them in the first half, and he still was end up behind. But does a lot of good things. You can see why he's been so successful here at the school.
It would be real easy for a Florida fan to be terribly discouraged, and I'm not going to try to make them confident against that Alabama bunch next week. But there is a feeling by some coaches not on the staff that Florida matches up a little bit better against that Alabama defense than they did here today against Florida State. Now, that doesn't mean the Gators are going to go in there a favorite. They're going to be a big underdog against that defense up there. But they get a chance to do some things because Alabama is not going to pull away from you offensively. They are not going to make this Florida team put 45 points on the board to beat them. That offense up at Alabama is not capable of that unless the defense gets some turnovers.
I agree with you, Brendan. You know what's impressive, though? Reggie Green, the freshman tackle, Jason Odom, the freshman tackle, are holding up very well and gets good pass rushers right here. Not the quality of Alabama's, but still very good pass rushers. And for freshmen, you're doing a very fine job.
Yeah, Curry and Copeland are in a league by themselves. Yeah, that'll be some matchup for them. Dean now goes to the end zone. Intercepted by Florida State. So Brown picks it off in the end zone. Seminoles ball at the 20.
Well, it was trying to go deep there, and there were three red jerseys right there. The free safety. Free safety was back there all the way. You'll see these two safeties over here. Now you just watch, they're gonna be there all day. Quarterback should be able to see those. So see those guys sagging back there, three deep zone. They're just sitting there. One's getting deep, and there's Brown, number 31, going up there. See? Normally, you'd say never throw the ball down the hole with that guy sitting there like that. That's what you tell a quarterback.
And Ward nimbly stepping away from trouble and getting the ball into Kez McCorvey's hands.
You talk about, you see that snap delivery? He gets outside the pocket, he's moving, and he just snaps it. I see why he sort of idolizes Randall Cunningham, but you know, he has a quicker, smoother, more natural throwing action than Randall Cunningham.
Might be. Might be number one, fellas.
Might be.
I got an injured player right now. So in the meantime, let's go down and meet the young man's father. Daniel should be all right, but let's go down and meet Charlie Ward's father, Mark Jones. Mark?
Yeah, Brent Dick, I'm with the other Charlie, Charlie Ward Sr. How would you assess Junior's performance today?
Real fine, and I think they finally found an offense that fits his personality.
Good that you would mention that. You coached him in high school in Thomasville, Georgia. Did you maybe put a bug in Coach Bowden's ear? Would you?
Well, the assistant coach is not Coach Bowden. No one's talked to Coach Bowden but the assistant coaches. But they finally found where he's happy. Once the ball is in his hand and they let him read the field, that's his strong point.
Any thoughts, Coach, about when you take him out of this game? It's pretty much in hand.
I believe they're trying to get a record. He said, yeah, I need one more touchdown pass, I believe.
So you do keep track of all those things,
huh? Yes, we can't help it. You people help us.
Back to you guys. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Mark. And Charlie Sr. and Charlie's mother both attended Florida A&M right here in Tallahassee, nearby the Florida State campus. And the young man, not too far, lives in Georgia, led the Georgia high school All-Stars, passed the Florida Stars. That's how good he was in high school, and he rolls for the first in. And if you're wondering about what the Rattlers are doing, they got their hands full against Bethune-Cookman. 21-7, second quarter of that game. And they're wondering why Pops didn't send the offspring there, aren't they? Charlie Ward, he's the point guard for the basketball team here, coached by Pat Kennedy, and he just enjoys the distance back there in the shotgun, that he can see the whole field like he does when he comes down the floor dribbling the ball. He likes to take it on the move like he is right here. That ball should have been caught, shouldn't it, by McCorvey? One of the few drops.
A little bit behind him, but I mean, he's made that kind of catch before. See, they're coming with that late blitz like that. He sees it, but, and now they're starting to pick up the guy that was knocking him down there in the first half on that late blitz by turning that running back out on him.
The most points ever scored by Florida State against Florida, 52. That was back in the late 80s. The Gators once put 53 on the board against the Seminoles. Ward standing tall, no pressure, fires to the open man. And out of bounds on the far side, Matt Fryer off the injury list, the receiver. And John Saunders, what do you got for an update?
To the SEC, Brent, Mississippi State, and Ole Miss. Corey Philpott quickly threw the hole, 7 yards on the touchdown, 14-10. Ole Miss is on top. Brent.
That one's going to be a dandy. 45-17 is the score here, John. Minute and three left in the third quarter. And the Seminoles moving into Florida territory for the second time in this half. Had 8 possessions in the first half. 5 touchdowns and a field goal. Threw behind the back, Sean Jackson.
You know, the other thing that shotgun does to the defense is it wears out those rushmen. You know, they're always working upfield to try to get to that guy, and they get tired.
Dickey has thrown for 313 yards here today against the Gators.
Not too bad. His best is 395. So he's not too far away.
And if you're wondering where they might go for a bowl game, if they don't wind up in a 1-2 situation against Miami, and again, that's going to be up to Florida, isn't it? It's probable that they'll get out of the Orange Bowl. Incomplete. There are several Orange Bowl officials in attendance, as are those from the Fiesta Bowl. If Miami and Florida State would happen to get back together for a 1-2, that game would take place in the Fiesta Bowl, but it is... most likely that if the situation doesn't change and Miami and Alabama stay 1-2, they go to the Sugar Bowl, and this team in all likelihood would go down to the Orange Bowl to play either Nebraska or Colorado. Nebraska could wrap it up if they beat Kansas State in Japan. So that's the situation on those major bowls as of right now. Pass high and snapped down out of the air. What a 28-yard line by Shannon Baker.
What a great leap. He's only 5'9". You talk about jump reach ability. He's the fastest man to ever play here at 4.28 in the 40. But what a leap.
45-17, Florida State all over Florida. With Dick Vermeil and Mark Jones, I'm Brent Musburger. The final 45 seconds of the third quarter, there is a penalty flag down on the field that is now being picked up following this reception, and if Ward was hit a little bit late on that, they're going to tack on some yardage. And here it comes.
They're still walking.
Now, if it's a personal foul, it's going to take him down inside the 15-yard line. So it is first and 10, and it was roughing the passer was the call. And Ward
going for more. Throws incomplete. Monty Groh in pursuit of the quarterback that time, and it is second and 10.
Defended by number 3, Larry Kennedy.
Knox and Vanover trot onto the field for the Seminoles. That haunting chant began outside Dick Vermeil's window about 6 o'clock this morning.
It did. Now I know how Custer felt.
There is Ward. Going high and intercepted by Larry Kennedy. Nice grab.
He's getting greedy now. See, they went short and long over there. But Kennedy didn't jump the short route run by Vanover. You'll see what I'm talking about right here. Now, see, watch. He's going to go up and try to draw the coverage. See, he's going to try to draw the coverage, and then they're going to throw the corner in behind him. But Kennedy fell back off. Nice job and well-coached defensive play.
Good cameraman. He knew right away that ball was going high when Vanover, huh?
Yeah.
Good picture.
All right, first and 10. 46 seconds. Here is the toss.
Stick
by Marvin.
Oh.
Marvin. Oh, bring the lumber, big fella. Bring it on.
Marvin, you are special. He is so quick at 4.5 in the 40, 235 pounds, not an ounce of fat on him. Great instinct, great reaction. And can he strike you?
That's not fair. He's picking on a freshman running back with his first carry, Tony Davis. So we're going to have the final 15 minutes from Tallahassee as Florida State leads Florida 45-17. Back after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Hitachi. They make great shot. Now, what was I saying?
Hitachi makes camcorders and 20,000 other products worth celebrating. Hitachi.
Hitachi? They make those little chips. They're in everything. They make things run.
Hitachi makes semiconductors and 20,000 other memorable products. Hitachi.
This isn't the Accord of the Camry you were talking about.
I know.
This is so sporty.
I got a V6 engine and standard anti-lock brakes.
Is it fun to drive?
It's great. The control and the power, you know, for passing and that kind of thing. And it was a couple thousand less than the Accord of the Camry.
Really? What is this?
It's a Pontiac, the new Grand Am.
Good for you.
She made national headlines.
She's a liar. Well, I'm a pervert.
And inspired an act of Congress.
My baby.
Based on the shocking true story, A Mother's Right Sunday.
Your business needs a computer. Their business needs a cleaning service. Bartering in today's business world has become a daily practice and is widely accepted. At the International Bankers and Exchangers, we can put your business in touch with the goods and services necessary to keep your business thriving. Call us today for information on bartering. It's simple and effective. International Bankers and Exchangers, for your business bartering needs.
This is WTXL, TV 27.
Here's Marvin Jones right here, the All-American linebacker. Here's Davis right here. Watch the collision. as he exploded.
That one hurt.
Yes, it did.
10 tackles
for Jones here this afternoon against the Gators. Dean hands it off, and Davis says, that time, you're not going to get me, and he pulled away from Jones.
Good job.
So Davis comes right back with a nice run of his own. Well done, young man.
Did a good job. He shows he has that burst of speed because he got running parallel, and he could run inside out away from people.
So they have not moved the chains, even though they've changed the down marker to first down. I think it's probably inches to go for a first down is my guess right here. And Davis comes right back and gets it. It explodes out to the 45-yard line. And let's take a look at the numbers through the third.
The two glaring things here, they're minus two right here, and they're minus 18 rushing right there. It's 445 yards to 227. A real display of offensive football.
Side of this score. Nice fake by Dean. 45 to the 40-yard line, and another first down for the Gators.
You know, he shows a lot more mobility than Shane Matthews. He ran for 516 yards as a high school quarterback and was rated in the top seven in the country as a quarterback. See, a strong fake, throw a good poise to hang on there, hold the ball, now get up. He's getting the block there from Jackson, number 22, and getting up there. Good mobility. He's going to make a run at this position next year.
Bilkey, the fullback, Davis, the tailback, Dean, the quarterback. Tied into his short side. And off a fake. Now sprinting and showing that running ability, and he'll go out of bounds inside the 35-yard line at the 34.
Brooks makes the defensive play.
Looking, talking about the future that with that quarterback. Look at, boy, they have a lot of people back. Of the 89 players, 56 are freshmen or sophomore. A bright future. And Spurrier told me yesterday that he didn't have his first great recruiting year until this past year.
Second down for Dean and the Gators. Here's Davis. And we check in with John Saunders for an update. John?
Right, Mississippi State and Ole Miss. This is Tony James returning this kickoff 45 yards. He is now the all-time record holder in NCAA history with 3,163 yards, breaking the old mark of Steve Odom of Utah back in the early 70s. Brent.
And John, here it's third and short for the Gators. They have moved to the Seminoles' 32-yard line. Simpson came crashing across into the offensive lineman. And if Golden moved first, that's going to be a costly 5A for the Gators. Drew him over. Yep, sure did.
Yeah, he moved first, big Dean Golden. He's been rotating as a starter with and changing off with David Swain at that same position.
Third down. Gators need to get to the 30-yard line. They're pressing Brent.
He sees it now.
Here they come. Hit on the release. Caught by Hill at the 4-yard line. Terrific job by Dean. Hit on the release by Fuller. They brought the safety blitz after him, and it's a 32-yard pass play. Well done.
He did a real good job that time. Earlier I mentioned he didn't see the blitz coming and he didn't respond to it. He took the hit. Here he saw it, he audibled, he got rid of it, and he took the hit. A real hit. But see, it's hard to pick that. Now you'll see you can tell a blitz is coming because everybody's up here. Only one safety back here. Now, this man right here will come late. See, hard to pick him up. But now he's getting smarter. Terry Dean sees him. He lays it up. They got the post pattern called. They audible to it. Nice job.
Well, let's see what Bilkey and Davis. And Dean uses a timeout. Something he didn't like about the defensive alignment. So he will go over and confer with Steve Spurrier. We'll take a break and come right back to Tallahassee.
Every now and then, people come across something so well thought out, so timeless, it becomes a classic. Which may explain why the Honda Accord has been the best-selling car in America for the past 3 years.
It's McDonald's Holiday Film Festival, now featuring the American epic Dances with Wolves. The original full-length video, unbelievably priced at just $7.99 when you buy any large sandwich. So hurry in and pick up Dances with Wolves. Also available, the family favorite, Babes in Toyland, and the hilarious Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. These films just $5.99 each when you buy any large sandwich. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
If you want to go places in any career, ask yourself, can I perform under pressure? Can I be counted on to get the job done? You can learn how in the Army, so when you're ready to take off, you'll know you can go far.
Ace means quality, so look for this name.
I know you're getting the very best.
Right, Dad.
Ace 25 outdoor light sets are only $5.88, and this Ace 45B socket set with lifetime warranty is just $18.88.
Ace label product.
Another reason why Ace is the place.
For you.
Undefeated Alabama hosts Florida for a trip to the USF&G Sugar Bowl. It's the SEC Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper next Saturday on ABC Sports.
A little unfinished business here, Dick, before Birmingham.
Throws that butt, post pattern, again split coverage, no free safety, one-on-one, right on the money. Nice job.
First and goal for the Gators. And it's Dean throwing that fade to Jackson for six. Hey, that's back-to-back superb passes by this young man.
He has grown, growing and growing and growing, gaining a little confidence.
He
didn't play very much. Nice job by Mr. Dean. He throws a quick fade right out there. Here comes the ball. See it at the top of your screen. There it is. Oh, nice job. Corey Sawyer is a darn good corner, too.
So Davis adds that extra point. There is a penalty flag down. Appeared to be a little offside by the defensive line, so the extra point is good.
That was a real good drive by Terry Dean.
45-24. A 21-point difference now. And an onside kick probably coming up.
She doesn't want to go back to work for a while. She likes staying home with the baby.
How's the baby now?
She's 2 months old tomorrow. I swear she's a genius.
Yeah.
No catchy jingles.
Look.
No images of snow-capped mountains.
She got lucky, I guess.
No rock stars.
You want another Heineken?
Yeah.
No sports stars.
You know, I've been getting them.
None of that is what made Heineken the number one imported beer in America.
So you like being a dad?
I wouldn't trade it for anything. I'm gonna try it.
You sound just like my in-laws.
With its distinctive aerodynamic shape, anti-lock brakes, advanced engine technology, and roomy interior, the Honda Civic EX sedan is often admired by other car makers. Some we know, some we don't.
This man's incredibly close, comfortable shave
comes from the Norelco razor. But to see how he got it, we must go back. Back to when he began shaving. Not just above the skin, but below it. Here, our lift and cut system lifts the hair so when it's cut, it can drop below skin level without the blades touching your face. Try it, and you'll keep going back. Back to Norelco for a perfect shave. Norelco, we make close comfortable.
Well, we have come to that fan-over moment again. He has hauled back three kickoffs for 80 yards, 76 yards, and 25 yards, but you've got to believe the Gators have got to take a crack at getting it back quickly.
Yeah, that's how to kick it to him.
Right along the ground, picked up at the 15-yard line by Floyd. And he is a tough sucker.
Yes, he is.
He gets to the 26-yard line and says, come on, who else wants to take a crack at me? Let's go.
They say he's not only the tough guy, he's also the team clown.
You'd be tough, too, if you had to take on Marvin Jones and scrimmages, folks.
Oh, man. No, I'd quit. I'd give it up. I'd throw it in there.
Coach, maybe I got to go to the chemistry lab today, and maybe I won't be able to scrimmage for you. First and 10 now for the Seminoles. And Ward with Floyd right directly behind him. And off a fake, still got it. And it's complete to Vanover, who is stopped. Forward progress was stopped back up toward the 30-yard line. Monty Groh there. Oh, that's McCorvey. I'm sorry. Let me check that.
That pass right there, Brent, was exactly what I've been talking about. Now, he's under pressure. He slips and falls. He gets up. He never shows that he's panicked. He just throws the strike.
He sure does.
Remember that Monday night play that Randall Cunningham made that a few years back? I mean, this guy has that same kind of balling. You know, just nothing rattles him.
Penalty being assessed, and a reminder again that Notre Dame and USC are coming up at... I want to remind everybody that it is 8 Eastern time. That's what it'll be. And that time, Dick, it was... one of the linemen downfield, ineligible receiver downfield in our game, and Notre Dame SC come your way at 8 Eastern time tonight from the Coliseum. Notre Dame has beaten the Trojans 9 straight years. Can that be right? Ward steps away from the pressure again and almost intercepted. Tried to drop it off to Shannon Baker, and Ben Hanks took a crack at it.
Broken up by number 11, Ben Hanks.
You know, they didn't pick up the stunt properly that time. Johnny Church, the defensive end, stunted. See him lined up right here. They run a cross charge, and Church gets in there. They didn't pick it up properly. Not a difficult stunt to pick up. They just didn't operate and switch it like they should. See, it turned him loose and put him under pressure. Now he keeps scrambling and throws it over there, almost throws the interception.
Second and 15 for the Seminoles. He's up under center. McMillan, the tailback. And it's Floyd, the fullback. And he was stopped at the 24-yard line by Daniels.
They better get back in their shotgun. You know. Only got a 21-point lead.
About 10 minutes to go for Spurrier. And he could always take a crack at blocking a punt if he can stop him here on this third down. Ward, it's beautiful protection, and fires to Baker, incomplete. Incomplete, and Florida State is forced to punt here with 9.5 minutes to go, leading by 21 points, and just a little thread of life for the Gators right now.
Charlie Ward trots off. You know, Brent, I was a high school coach in 1961 when I first saw the shotgun formation used by the 49ers. Red Hickey, I think, was the first one to ever really use it in professional football.
Scott Holmes trots onto the field. He is going to punt this ball for the Seminoles. The rush, and they don't get to it. Duncan fields it. Dances to the 42, and he is down. And a penalty flag comes flying. So hold on, everybody. Don't go away. We got a penalty marker down here on this one. can't believe it. Okay. It's 45-24. We got 9-24 on a face mask penalty.
Presenting the 190 horsepower Prelude VTEC. From Honda.
Hitachi?
Wait, I know. Name me.
Look, your favorite show.
Oh.
Hitachi makes big screen TVs and 20,000 other entertaining products. Hitachi.
Hitachi? They make, actually, I'm kind of busy right now working on a big project.
Hitachi makes computer systems and 20,000 other intelligent products. Hitachi.
If heaven were a place on earth, it would most likely be somewhere in California. And if you've ever wanted to come and see it for yourself, now's the perfect time. Because right now, Alamo is offering a special low rate on a new Geo Metro with unlimited free mileage. And at this special low rate for California, you can see a lot more for a lot less of what some people call one of the nicest places on earth.
So that's what it looks like from the front.
Four to go, and the backup quarterback, Dean, brings the Gators to the line of scrimmage. And incomplete, he wanted Jack Jackson that time. Hey, Dick, I know it's been a little boring for you sometimes. I haven't started a good rumor regarding you lately.
Here it comes.
Are you interested in the Auburn job at all?
No, thank you. Here you go again, Musburger. You've been doing this to me. When I was coaching, you used to do that to me.
I'm not going to let you go anyplace. I'm just kidding. But you do know Mike Lute up there, the athletic director.
No,
second down.
Been a long time.
Now Dean under center. Straight back, steps straight, brave, and a wonderful rush by Simpson.
Great rush. Came into the ballgame with 20 career sacks, a fine defensive move. He jumped underneath that time. He's been coming to the outside. Here he takes a move to the inside. Tough on an offensive lineman, especially a true freshman offensive lineman.
Now Florida State, favored by 16 points, leads this one by 21 right now, with 8:47 to go here in Tallahassee. Florida State ranked number 3. The voters, having watched Texas A&M beat up on Texas, can now sit back and evaluate the performance of Florida State. And a timeout has been called by the Gators.
University of Florida.
We'll be right back to Tallahassee.
State Farm sells life insurance. In fact, we've been there protecting hopes and dreams for families for over 60 years. And we're there for your family today with the life insurance value you're looking for. You see, the cost of State Farm life insurance is among the lowest in the industry. So, you get an outstanding value from a company with a long history of financial stability. Isn't that what you're looking for in a life insurance plan for the people who are counting on you?
Love you.
State Farm sells life insurance. Not only is this Honda Accord designed to improve airflow, but cash flow as well. Introducing the Accord Lease Program. See your nearest dealer for details.
New Skill FlexiCharge Cordless Tools all share the same battery pack. So when you need a recharge, they keep on working. The FlexiCharge Interchangeable Power System from Skill.
4,573 real NFL plays of real NFL teams are now available in your living room.
Graduate student.
Graduate 25 to 24. Third and 20 for the Gators. Now Dean.
He got it.
Did he get the first down?
No.
No, just short of that. That was Jack Jackson, and Fowler made the hit.
That was a good call, see, because they bought time with that sprint out action to allow the crossing pattern to come all the way across, and they stretched the field with a receiver over there and bought him in between it, but he's just not deep enough.
So here it comes. Fourth down, a couple of yards.
You know, they were 13 for 16 in converting fourth down situations this year. Pretty darn good.
Let's see what Dean comes up with.
They should play him in man coverage.
He's sneaking, diving right straight ahead. I'm not so sure he got it, but let's see where they spot it.
That's the longest sneak attempt I've seen.
Wow.
That's over 2 yards.
I don't think they have any timeouts left, do they?
No, they don't. The scoreboard says they don't. Yeah. Hey, Coach.
But, Coach, they're gone.
You've had too many sessions on the sideline there, boy. The quarterback had to.
Won too many blitzes when he was out in San Francisco. I think. I mean, the scoreboard says that there are none left. George Hill, is that confirmed?
Yeah, they're out. Made it. Hey, that's a, you know, a fourth and two.
Whoa,
quarterback
a long snake.
That's a long snake. Woo! That's like running the Green Bay sweep. You know, it's a long way to go.
So the ball is at the Seminoles' 42-yard line. They really need to pick up the tempo without any timeouts and in need of a miracle. They have got to get after it. Dean has been nifty. Run down from behind, and that was Mr. Footman who tackled the quarterback. And there's a penalty, a face mask, I believe, on this play.
Florida's got to pick up their intensity.
Face mask, defense, 5 yards, end of the run.
Scrambling out of there. Footman, number 58. See, he's going to reach in right there. See, you can see it right there. He's got it. Danny Footman, boy, can he run. He's a junior college transfer out of Northwest Mississippi. He can move.
Well, that puts him down in second and short territory now. Rhett is the running back. Jackson's and Everett. The wide receivers. Dean sprinting to the right and away from trouble. Throws incomplete. Willie Jackson working that sideline. And over there also was Fowler, the defender.
You know, many times when you roll out against a defensive team and the quarterback gets out there, once you get out there, you feel pretty comfortable. But these defensive linemen can run so well, you can never just sort of ease up and make the nice deliberate throw. There's somebody breathing down your neck. You might as well stay in the pocket. The trouble with the rollout, it restricts the area you have left to throw the football to.
Second, Dean with time. Should have been intercepted by Sawyer. Right through his hands.
It was too easy. He's already made seven of them. That I didn't want to keep leading the country. I'll just let that one go.
So he throws one back because it's too easy. He's like the fisherman.
Yeah. You know, Florida State's defensive secondary is made up of high school quarterbacks. This kid was an all-state quarterback. Sauer was.
Let's go!
Everett and Jackson off the Dean's right. Ricky and Rhett. Third down. Rhett dives up over the top.
and may have given Florida a fresh set of downs inside the 35, the 32-yard line.
You know, there's many different ways to get signals with a person on the sideline, Brent. Many times what they do is they number the areas of the body. And so you touch like your knee, that might be four. So you run play four in your program.
Spurrier very upset on that sideline. Came out on the field. It is fourth and inches. Spurrier furious over there.
He must want a measurement.
He kicked the ball. He kicked the ball back. Oh, you're a fucking.
Well, this is a lot shorter than the other one. Maybe Dean will just keep it. And now the defense asks for a timeout.
Thank you.
Now that's the first
timeout.
Timeout, and the always calm Mr. Spurrier.
Talking there with Mr. Alexander. Defensive coaches, Chuck Amato there.
Well, we've got a chance here, Dick. Let me remind everybody, because I know we're cutting into some of that time, that coming up next from the Bighorn Golf Club in Palm Desert, California, it is the Skins competition. There are your four competitors, Freddie Couples, Tom Kite, Payne Stewart's the defender, and the shark, Greg Norman. And we will be seeing full coverage of that coming up next here on ABC. I don't know whether it's my imagination, but I think the officials have been very slow today in making decisions, getting penalties marched off.
They have
getting
been.
Straight as to what is happening and
getting
the pace
coordinated with us in the timeouts. And
yeah, it's been a kind of a herky-jerky.
Yeah, they've had a
thing
going on. They've had a good day.
6:14 to go. 45-24, and here it is. Fourth down. Gators trailing it by three scores. Watch out, play action pass. He's left to do it. But a man over on the nose on fourth and short. And Dean battered, twist free, and may have extended there at the end for the Florida first down as the officials stop the clock. And the play coming in from the sideline indicates that the Gators do have a first down.
Boy, this offensive line is really going to be good for Florida next year. Left tackle, freshman, left guard, sophomore, center, junior, right guard, junior, right tackle, freshman, tight end, junior, all back and growing.
They have really held up here today. This scoreboard is not any kind of an indication as to how well they play. Dean standing in the pocket, goes for Jackson, incomplete. And he was thrown into double coverage that time, wasn't he? Abraham was the cornerback back there with Jack Jackson. Defended by Abraham and Davis. Now it'll be second down and 10 for the Gators.
Brent, they're giving him more mixtures of coverage, but more man-to-man coverage than you would anticipate leading this way. They might really want to go to some crossing-type patterns. Now, it looks like they're going back to zone here.
Red is the running back. Dean comes back to Willie Jackson, incomplete. Almost caught it after it was off Sawyer's hand.
See, they don't have a receiver out in the flat to hold the corner who's rolled up to prevent him from dropping back in there. See, that route is designed to run against the free safety or safety rotating over, but no receiver in the rolled up corner. You'll see what I mean. You have two frees right there. See, this defender right here, if you had a receiver up in here, would keep him out of there, then it would be one-on-one.
Third and 10. Dean thought for a moment he might have had something going. Dean firing complete and a first down at the 19-yard line. That was for the Gators. That was Monty Duncan who did it, huh?
Yeah, he's getting pumped up. Good for Terry Dean. He has really gained some confidence in this whole series that he's been in here.
He's done fine for him.
Done a fine job. Number one in his class in high school.
It's 7-7 in the in the second half.
Yeah.
I don't know if that counts for anything. But I thought I'd pass it along. First and 10. Ball is at the 19, and
Dean, a good runner. There's a penalty flag down, however.
Dean? Dean, don't do that,
Dean.
Thinks he's Emmett Smith or Neil Anderson.
Courageous young man.
Declined after that gain by Dean.
Offsides, defense, decline, first down.
See, when you lose that edge of intensity, you have that big lead, boy, it's tough to turn it back on and become the team you were prior to losing it.
First and goal for the Gators. There's that fade that struck last time, and this time he overthrows Willie Jackson, but Jackson is able to get free on that corner. Henry was in pursuit of him, and he had him beat again.
They're actually beaten better this time than the one they completed for the touchdown.
You bet. That's a lethal play, isn't it, Coach?
It is. It is tough. You know, and I was fortunate enough when I was coaching, I had that big 6'8" guy, Harold Carmichael.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't do it enough. So help me, God. When I think back now, I said, what a dumb guy. I should have been. Really? I didn't do it enough.
Now here's Dean again. This is second and goal. Well, they heard you. They threw for the corner again, and that time, Henry had backed off, and he's barking away down there at Jackson.
They're talking back and forth. These kids, some of them played against each other in high school or played in all-star games with each other or against each other in all-star games. So,
yeah, they've been talking to each other since their Pop Warner days, some of these youngsters. 4:42 to go. What great talent there is down here in the state of Florida. Three wonderful college programs, and then so many other schools come down here and recruit, especially when they're looking for speed for their running backs and their defensive backs. Always stop off in Florida, don't they? Here's third and goal over the middle, incomplete. The umpire had to jump down out of the way, and Jack Jackson.
He did the right thing. He knew where he was supposed to go. He saw the coverage. He was coming back inside on the linebacker.
Maybe they'll go back to that tight end play that scored for him down here in the first half.
You know, a play like that normally only works once, Brent, but it's been a long time, you know, and you have to catch him in that same kind of defensive scheme, but it's well-designed, and it's a good concept, and it could work again.
They've only got 10 seconds to get this ball snapped. They don't have any timeouts. They're going to have to hurry. The 25-second clock is inside of five. Dean sees it. Dean's got to hurry. They don't get it off. A costly mistake.
Sometimes that's not always the quarterback's fault. Sometimes they're late at getting the play in. You know?
Delay on the offense, 5 yards. Previous spot, still fourth down.
Delay of game penalty assessed against the University of Florida.
Well, Florida is 2-for-2 on fourth downs on this drive, but Dean is not about to keep it himself this time.
No, plus right now you can, you know, inside that 10-yard line area, like you can go right up nose to nose with the receivers and crowd them and force them to throw the perfect pass.
Everett, the slot man, the two Jacksons, and Dean gets time, throws, deflected in the end zone, incomplete. Coverage by Henry. Oh, Henry, what a job.
He's been Terrell Buckley's backup here for a few years. Right there, he played like a legitimate starter. Good football player.
Florida State holds off the Gators. Four and a half minutes to go, and Florida State closing in on a win that is going to impress certainly the voters in the AP poll. Floyd busts up the middle to the 20-yard line.
They impress me. You have my vote. I don't have one, but I'd give it to them.
Well, the Associated Press poll, and that's the one the coalition will be using this year to help it determine the matchups for the various big games. Bobby Bowden and the Seminoles, of course, their dream matchup would be a rematch against Miami out in the Fiesta Bowl, but they're going to need help from these same Gators. Next week, they need Alabama to lose.
Then they could climb into that runner-up spot, provided that Miami beats San Diego State. Texas A&M has an argument, though, and it is a strong one based on how national champions have been chosen in the past. They are unbeaten. Notre Dame plays USC a little bit later on ABC. Florida certainly going to slip as the result of this loss here in Tallahassee this afternoon. And, of course, the question with the Gators now becomes, if they should lose against Alabama, do they go to the Citrus Bowl or will they go to the Gator Bowl in Jacksonville? Because Georgia is still very much in the running for the Citrus Bowl. And we understand in talking to the sports editor from Orlando, fine writer over there, Larry Guest, I spoke to him before the game, that has been some tough going with that committee over there in Orlando. There's a lot of Gator fans over there. And,
you got a split crowd.
They'd like to see Florida in there. And meanwhile, there are some Georgia backers down Orlando way. They'd like to see the Bulldogs go in. And so I suppose a lot will be determined as to how the Bulldogs do in that game today against Georgia Tech coming up a little bit later. And here are the Seminoles. Done a wonderful job. You know, it's interesting, the two PR departments, and they're both excellent ones down here in the state of Florida. But you pick up the releases, folks. Now, here in Florida State, this is how they tell you that they're the winningest active coaches. Joe Paterno with 247. There's Bobby with 225. But then I picked up the Florida release, and that suddenly, well, there's Osborne number one, Bobby, Steve Spurrier's number seven. And now think about that one for a moment, folks. Let me show you how Florida figures it out. Here is the handoff, and the 25-yard line with the money play. This is the reason, you see, they did it by percentages. That was sneaky. What you can do, folks, with numbers when you're in the mood to prove a pointer. Our guy's really good. That's great.
And I think the only way Steve Spurrier is ever going to get up in that category of number of wins is by percentage ranking, because I think the National Football League will steal him out of college football.
Do you really?
And he won't last long enough to win 240 games.
You know, I think that's a ways down the road, to tell you the truth.
Really?
Yeah, I must tell you that he lived with my buddy Steve Melnick.
Mm-hmm.
And he talks to Steve, and he's very happy over there at Gainesville. He enjoys his golf and doesn't mind recruiting. He really seems content. Now, I'm not saying that you're not going to be right about this down the road. That the fella that I wouldn't be surprised. Oh, here I go again. My man Dennis Erickson down Miami way.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised either.
Now, that's the fella that the NFL's got to have an eye on. He has done that's just one of the great coaching jobs down there, that he stepped in there. They've had that turmoil down in Miami with Hurricane Andrew and all the tragedy that followed that.
And he rebuilds an inexperienced team and has a number one. You know, that offensive line, he put them all back together.
Is this a great state to be a fan of college football or what?
A better place to coach. Really, I mean, you want to be smart as a football coach. You come down here and get one of these main jobs, you have to screw it up to lose. You really do. Not that they aren't doing a good job of coaching, but this guy's been doing a great job for a long time, the man you see on that screen. You know, they wouldn't be building this new stadium if they weren't winning. You know, going back to hiring and firing coaches and all that kind of stuff.
He came in here 17 years ago.
That's right.
And he has made this a major program. In the old days, folks, other than Florida and Miami, no good teams would come in here to play. Bobby Bowden had to take a show on the road. He became the road warrior. And he did the job, didn't he? There's a run by Sean Jackson. Jackson scored a touchdown, seems like the day before yesterday. Ed Robinson gets him down. With a win, you become the only coach in NCAA history to have six straight 10-win seasons, five straight 10-win seasons. Bud Wilkinson at Oklahoma and the Bear. Up the road, Alabama and Tuscaloosa.
How many of those winning seasons do you think he would trade for one Miami win?
Unbelievable. They've cost him, I think, three national championships that I can think of, Dick.
Yeah.
Two for sure. I think it was a third one, and might have gotten a fingernail on that one. Holmes punched to Duncan, and he's buried there at the 36-yard line. And we bring down the final minute here in Tallahassee with the Florida State Seminoles in impressive fashion. Going to beat their arch rivals, the Florida Gators, and I go back to what we said at the top of the show. Just the moment that this one ends, the biggest Gator fans in this state are the Seminole fans. They are going to be pulling so hard for Florida to go in there and upset Alabama so they can get another crack at Miami. It is going to be something.
They'll play. It'll be a heck of a football game.
Yeah, you better, bro. You better, bro. I think you like Alabama because of the defense, don't you, Dick?
Yeah, I do. I do. I just think they're so overpowering on defense, Grant, that it might be just a little too much to overcome. And this offensive team will give them some problems.
Penalty marker down on the pass. I must say that I think young Dean has stepped in here under a difficult situation and has played quite well. He can be pleased with his performance, and I know that we wondered about what kind of a message was going to be sent.
Defense.
With the benching of Shane Matthews, but heck, no one complains.
No,
what
he
did, huh?
Well, you know, obviously. The head coach knows what this young man can do and wanted to give him the opportunity to do it. Good job, man, and ends up being a good decision.
One of the things that Steve cannot be against Alabama, okay? He cannot be impatient. When you go in against a team like that, you've got to take what they give you defensively.
I think he's got to come up with a protection scheme to help his tackles. No matter how good these young freshman tackles are and how much they've improved, they haven't met this kind of a down, powerful, big defensive line rushman. They've met linebackers that can rush quickly, but not guys like he's going to meet in Curry and Copeland.
Seconds ticking away. And he goes down on the fumble. Scooped up by the Seminoles.
And that's called dead.
All dead. This will not be the record breaker.
Derek had a shot. Take a look at the end zone. Derek Alexander's a down defensive lineman. There's the ball on the ground right to the left center of your screen. Here he comes. He's through.
Exactly. Why was that whistle dead?
I don't know.
You have any reason for that?
Huh?
That would cap off their day. They're not moving up in the polls. I got news for you. You got to give him an after award. Hope he pays his dues for the amount of time he spent on the camera today. And if I was the Gators, I'd be hoping that this crew didn't show up in Birmingham next week, by the way. Oh, that's piling on. I apologize. 6 seconds. I have a soft spot for officials everywhere.
Well, you do, I don't.
They kneel down, and that's it. Great win for the Florida State Seminoles. And the crowd here in Tallahassee appreciates it.
That's the end of the ball game. The final score, Florida State 43.
The Chevrolet Most Valuable Players of the Game. Willie Jackson from Florida. Tamarick Vanover from Florida State. Chevrolet donates $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. And now the Seminoles are saying we love the win, but go Gators. For Dick Reveal and Mark Jones, I'm Brent Musburger. We bid you a fond adieu from Tallahassee, where Bobby Bowden has done it. 45-24 over Florida.